the Carolina Panthers head coach, Ron Rivera, here on the Rich Eisen Show. How are you, Coach?
Doing good, Rich. How are things?
I am doing just fine. How do you keep your players hungry after pushing the rock so far up that hill to the Super Bowl last year, Coach?
Well, I think the biggest thing more so than anything else, Rich, is we just talked about the fact we didn't finish the job. I mean, that's the truth of the matter. You know, we accomplished an awful lot, but at the end of the day, we just didn't win it all. So I think, you know, the attitude's been really good. I think guys understand, you know, that we have to have a certain focus, and so far, so good.
And so how is Cam Newton coming to camp? Is he still the same guy? Does he have a different focus based on what happened in that game last year and also post-game, Coach?
Yeah, I think he's the same guy. I really do. You know, he's, you know, learned from the experience he had last season, learned from the experience he had in the Super Bowl. And I think he gets it and he understands it. You know, he is who he is, though. I mean, that's the truth of the matter. The young man is a guy who just does not like to lose football games. And he takes it very hard. He takes it very personal.
And so when it comes down to this team's personality, who does it emanate from, in your estimation, Coach?
Wow, you know, that's a tough question just because we have so many different types of personalities on this football team. You know, but I'd like to believe that, you know, we as a football team try to establish who we are in terms of physical play up front. You know, we've rushed for over 100 yards in 28 straight games, I believe it is. And, you know, during that period, we're something like 23-5. So I think, you know, knowing that and understanding that's one of our goals is to be a physical football team, I think that has helped. I think guys that, you know, play the game a specific way, do certain things a specific way, I mean, it's all about them having a personality of their own and then coming together as a football team. And that's the thing I thought that happened to us last year is that we came together as a football team.
Panthers coach Ron Rivera joining me here on the Rich Eisen Show right now. Look, all fans know, and certainly you being a defensive-minded former player and coordinator and now head coach, successful head coach in this league, knows that when you've got a quality corner, you foster that. When you've got a high-quality corner, you don't get rid of him. And certainly when you've got an all-pro corner, you don't just give him away for nothing. What was it like from your perspective to watch what was going down between the team and Josh Norman, Coach?
Well, I think the truth of the matter is, and at the end of the day, you know, it was something that we as a football team had to absorb. I think, you know, with in the era of salary cap and the way things are today, you have to identify and you have to go out and keep. And Josh was a guy we felt we wanted to keep. I don't think it was one of the things where we had to keep. And that was probably the biggest thing that we learned and we understood. And so going forward, you know, as long as we can keep the rush going, the linebackers flowing and doing things that they need to, you know, we should be okay. I feel pretty confident, comfortable in who we have up front. I think those guys can attack. I like our safeties position. I think that's really been a solid performer for us the last couple of years, and Kurt Coleman really stepped up last year. So I think these young corners have an opportunity to step in, and I think they have a chance to help us out.
Did Josh ever ask you or the team to be part of the media during the playing season in the same way that apparently he's going to be doing this year with the Redskins?
No. But I will say, I do know ESPN had him in studio twice during the regular season. And, you know, and quite honestly, I thought Josh did a nice job. But, you know, it's going to be interesting to see him when he has to do it every week.
Yeah, but so what would your stance be on that as a coach? Obviously, you know, as again, a longtime player in this league, you know that players need to get ready for the next career because you never know if you're just one snap away from that career needing to start. So what's your take on players being part of the media during the season?
Well, the biggest thing more so than anything else is it's not something distraction. I think that's the thing that we have to look at as coaches, and I do agree with you. A lot of these young men are looking toward their future careers. And, you know, I get that part of it as well. But, again, it comes back to is it becoming a distraction or is it a distraction? That's the thing you have to be careful of. And, you know, we'll see how it goes. I mean, it, you know, it's their situation, their set of circumstances, but you know, for a lot of us, we'll get an opportunity to see how it goes.
And what if a player did it without even asking you if it's cool to do it?
Well, again, it goes back to it that as long as it's not a distraction, it doesn't cut into what his responsibilities are to the football team,
right.
We'll have to make it work.
And, the Redskins are already saying that Norman's bringing a certain attitude and a certain nastiness to the back end of the defense that they like a lot. How do you replace something like that now that that's gone from the back end of your defense from that one individual, Coach?
Well, you'd like to believe that we have some guys that can step up and make plays. And as I said, we feel very good about, who our safeties are. I mean, Kurt Coleman proved himself last year. Trey Boston has shown that he's a player in waiting. He can make plays and do things, given opportunity. So I think this will be their time to help set the tone and template. Again, I think a lot of our stuff starts up front for us. I believe our front four can really help and show the physicality. I think our linebackers can produce and create that type of explosive play that you're looking for. And, again, as I said, I think we got some young corners that can really step in and help us out as we go forward.
And you have played with some of the best. You played with distinction yourself at the linebacker position. How good is Luke Kuechly on people that you've seen of all time?
I think Luke ranks right up there. I mean, and with all respect to Mike Singletary and Brian Urlacher and the other great middle linebackers that I've coached, I think this young man, it should be or is going to be mentioned in the same breath as a Mike Singletary, as a Brian Urlacher.
Well, we already heard that. Ronnie Lott was on our Super Bowl show last year and said Kuechly reminded him of Singletary. That's what he said.
Well, and again, coming from Ronnie, that's tremendous praise. I think the world of who he was as a football player and even more so who he is as a man. So, I think that's great praise. And I think, Luke is earning that. He's done the things the right way. He's played as physical as anybody else. And he truly is a team player. So, I really do appreciate Ronnie's perspective on our player.
So what more can you expect out of him then?
Well, it's funny because people ask me about about us. What else can we do? What else can Cam do to get better? What else can Luke do? Well, I think we can play more consistent as a football team. I think both guys, if you sit down and talk to them about certain things, they'll be happy to point things out. Hey, we didn't play well in this game. We gave up too many yards here, or we didn't play well in this game offensively because we missed opportunities. I mean, I think we have to continue to work and try to grow and get better as a football team.
And then obviously adding Kelvin Benjamin back to the mix has got to be a help. How's he looking right now?
He's looking really good, Rich. And one of the things that we had to do is we had to bring him back slowly because, again, he really didn't do the hard football stuff during OTAs and minicamp. So his first real exposure was when we started training camp. And so we've tried to really monitor it, waiting for that 100% let's go, get him rolling. Well, we were just given that. So we're pretty excited about him going out there now and doing the types of things that he had done in the past. And again, he adds another dimension to what we want to do on the offensive side. He's really going to help out with, creating another weapon for Cam to use and another weapon that's going to help him be explosive for our offense in terms of ability to score. So we can be a better football team. Again, it really just depends if we're ready to roll.
Now, when you're coaching this team and you hear some of the things that come out of your mouth, Ron Rivera, who does it from your past come out of your mouth that you say, wow, that really sounded like fill in the blank from your past? Who's that person?
It just depends on the situation. I think I've taken an awful lot from a lot of the coaches I've been around. I've been very fortunate, very blessed to have been around some great coaches. And there's some guys that I still work with now that have helped me tremendously. John Madden has been a guy that's been on my side and has really helped me the last 4 years and helped me to develop as a football coach. So I think it just depends on the situation and circumstances. Sometimes when I lose my mind, it reminds myself of Coach Dick. And other times when I'm getting down into the analytics portion of the game, I feel like Andy Reid. And when I get into those blitz happy situations, I just reminds me of Buddy Ryan and Jim Johnson. So, like I said, I've been very fortunate. There's been a lot of great coaches I've been around.
What's your favorite Buddy Ryan story? What do you have?
There's so many of them. I think one of my favorite was the time that he put me in charge of Dan Hampton, and I had to make sure Hamp was where he was supposed to be. And, it's one of those things. And when you're a young guy, and the coordinator says, if he gets in trouble, I'm going to make sure it's your ass that gets kicked. I said, okay, got him.
And how'd it work out for you?
It worked out good. Are you kidding? I got him back into the hotel at curfew, just like he was supposed to be. In fact, we pulled into the hotel at curfew, just as Buddy Ryan was pulling in at the same time, and he gave me a big thumbs up, so I was okay on that.
Oh, I thought it was just to make sure he was lined up in the right spot on the field. You mean just physically somewhere he had to be at night?
Oh yeah, no, yeah, we never worried about Ham. Ham was going to show up and play like a maniac, like who he is, like the Hall of Famer he is. It was when we would go out and go out to dinner and have a couple of beers, stuff like that. He wanted to make sure that that I got him back to the hotel in good shape and ready to roll for the next day.
Last question for you: is it true that you were the initial first person that the paint team wanted to have a statue for in between the two growling Panthers out there? But you just decided let Mr. Richardson be the guy out there with the statue. Is that a true story, Coach?
I have no idea about that. So I was on vacation, and the people that were doing to put this surprise together for him, they were trying to get hold of me to tell me, hey, we're going to have this big event, but they couldn't reach me. And then all of a sudden, I get this note in the mail saying, hey, they're going to do this nice presentation for our owner. Mm-hmm. Lo and behold, there's this gigantic statue there.
Yeah, it is, and it's menacing. I mean, he's standing out there with the football. He's not even acknowledging these growling animals to his right and his left. It's impressive.
But you know, the symbolism is him bringing football to the Carolinas. And that's, that's what I took from when I saw it. That was my first impression was, what a very appropriate statue that, Mr. Richardson having brought football to the Carolinas.
Oh, I thought it was like I was in the greatest game ever played. I don't care about these animals at my feet screaming at me. What do
well,
I?
That too. I tell you, he's an imposing figure. He's a big, big man.
He is. And, oh, God, I guess I lied. Last question for you. Cam says he's no longer dabbing. He's got something new this year. Do you know what it is? Have you seen it in practice?
No, I have no idea. Okay. I really don't. I'll tell you, our practices get so competitive, too. It's unbelievable. Him and Thomas Davis get going, and then the rest of the team joins in. And I got to be quick with the whistle because, those guys are ready to get out.
Oh, I remember last year with him and Norman. I'm sure you did, too.
I will say this, though. When that situation came up, you talk about bringing a team together. It was amazing because when it first happened, I was concerned. But what happened was the other leaders, other team captains came up to me and said, Coach, we'll take care of this. And so I didn't have to get up in front and give this speech about being teammates or anything. The players did it. They took care of it. And I tell you, I think that type of thing brought it together because, I think Josh doing what he did, say, hey, I don't care who you are, I'm fighting you. And the quarterback says, well, I don't care who you are, I'm fighting. And in a weird way, it's one of those guy things, but I think it helped us.
Well, there you go. So now, of course, you're going to tell somebody just, take Cam down just for a quick second so you can do it again this year, right? That's coaching. That would be coaching.
Well, I think that's already been established. So I think we'll be okay.
Coach, thanks for taking the time. Good luck down the road. Hope to chat with you during the season.
I appreciate it, Rich. Thank you very much.
You got it. That's Ron Rivera.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.